In this video, we're going to talk about the Hausdorff spaces and then define convergence. Remember that if you want to support the channel, there are several ways for you to do this. You can either buy books on Amazon using our affiliate links, you can also make very small donations on Ko-fi, or you can become a member of Patreon to get access to exclusive benefits and merchandising. Let's begin with the video. We say that a topological space X is a Hausdorff space if, whenever we have two elements in the space, there exist disjoint neighborhoods of each of those points. So, if my space, let's say that it's this one, this is X, and whenever I grab two elements, X and Y, there always exist two open neighborhoods, U and B, that are disjoint. So, U and B being neighborhoods means that they are open sets that contain X and B contains Y. So these are two open sets disjoint. If we can do this for every X and Y in our space X, then we say that our space is Hausdorff. You can also find this in the literature as a T2 space, but this notation is not actually the best because of something that we will see when we talk about the separability axioms. So in this reproduction list anyways, we are going to just ignore it. We will call them just Hausdorff spaces. And the thing is, well, why do we want to separate these types of spaces from the usual ones? I mean, up to this point, we were talking about topological spaces in a general way and finding results in those spaces. So why are we now focusing on a specific set of spaces called the Hausdorff spaces? The reason for that is actually very simple, and it's because, in a way, we want to ignore the spaces that do not behave in a comfortable manner. We are used to working in the real line, and one of the things that we have defined for real numbers is the convergence of sequences. And whenever we have a sequence and we write the limit of that sequence, we know that if that limit exists, then it's unique. And that property that may sound very trivial, the uniqueness of the limit, is one of those properties that every time we define the concept of a limit, we have to prove. But it's always so trivial, and it sounds so silly to be proving that. Well, when we change the topology of the space, that property may no longer be trivial, and may even no longer be valid. So let's define the convergence and then see why this could be a problem. We have a sequence in the topological space X, and we say that this sequence converges to a point in the space if for each neighborhood U of the point that we want to call the limit point, there exists a natural number such that there are an infinite amount of elements in the sequence in that open neighborhood. So again, if this is our space, and I have a sequence, let's say that this point is X, I will say that this sequence converges to X if every time that I take a neighborhood of X, there is some number n such that all the Xn for n greater than this n are inside this neighborhood. So I can always find infinitely many points here. And this has to happen for each open set I take. So if I take a smaller one, then I have to be able to find an infinite amount of elements in my sequence inside. This definition of a limit is the same that we have in the real numbers. The usual definition was that for each epsilon greater than zero, there exists n, a natural number, such that xn minus x is smaller than epsilon for every n greater than or equal to n. So this is the usual definition of convergence. And if you think about it, it's the same as this one, because what we are considering here is we are saying that xn is in the ball centered at x with radius epsilon. So for each radius, if we can find an infinite amount of elements in my sequence that are inside each ball centered in the limit, then we say that the sequence converges to X. And here we're doing the same, but with a more general neighborhood. Instead of taking a ball, we're just taking an element in my topology. Now the problem is, why do we need to define Hausdorff spaces? Well, let's consider a particular topology. Let's say that we have a set X, and we consider on this set the topology of the empty set and the whole set. Now let's just take some sequence. Then when we want to see if the sequence converges to an element X, the answer will always be yes. And the reason for this is that when we go to the definition of convergence, it says for each neighborhood U of X. So there are two possible neighborhoods of X. The empty set, which is not a neighborhood because it doesn't contain the element X, or the whole set. So given X, Xn is an element of X for every n. And given that this X is the neighborhood that I was taking, then we can say that the sequence converges to X. So in this space, in some set with the trivial topology, sequences converge to every point. So there is no unique limit. And this is the type of behavior that I mentioned that we wanted to avoid when working with topological spaces. If we want to continue studying the subject, we have to remove all the spaces that behave incorrectly, such as any set with a trivial topology. We can also prove that this space is also not Hausdorff. And again, the reason is very trivial. If we take two elements in the set, then the only possible neighborhood we can take is the whole set. And obviously, it's not disjoint with itself, so it's trivially not Hausdorff. However, if we talk about the real line with a standard topology, or given X and Y, we can always take epsilon to be a number smaller than the distance between X and Y. So what we're doing is, if this number is X and here is Y, then the interval X minus epsilon, X plus epsilon over 2, and the set Y minus epsilon over 2, Y plus epsilon, these two sets are sort of like this, where this is X minus epsilon and X plus epsilon over 2, and like this, Y plus epsilon, Y minus epsilon over 2. So these are two neighborhoods of X and Y that are disjoint, and because they are open sets, then they are obviously in the standard topology of the real line. What about the other topologies of the real line? We have RL, RU, RF, RC, and many more. Why don't you try and prove if these spaces are Hausdorff?